On board the trucks were 500 rifles. They'd once belonged to the Irish Territorials, but following re-equipment, had been kept in storage for just such a crisis. Their destination, IRA units in the north. The equipment was loaded in such haste that the next day, dozens of gas masks littered the road to the border. Guns were on the way.
To whom would those arms have gone had they crossed the border?
They would have gone into Ballymurphy and whoever was capable of handling, using and directing their organisation. Without name, not because I have the name, but because I just don't know.
But they would have gone, presumably, to the newly emergent provisionals.
Probably. Probably.
Because you say they wouldn't have gone to the officials.
Hmm?
You say they wouldn't have gone to the
officials. Oh, no way. No way.
It was beginning to look as if Ulster in general, and Belfast in particular, had some reason to be proud of this Easter holiday. But round about 7 o'clock last night, here at the top of the big Catholic Ballymurphy estate, started 6 hours of the worst rioting to hit Belfast since last August. It started soon after a large Catholic crowd had gathered to watch the homecoming of a junior Orange Lodge from the day's big Protestant rally. And it escalated after the Protestants had dispersed into a vicious confrontation between the Royal Scots and 500 angry Catholics.
Thank you. After six successive nights of trouble in Belfast, the army find their relations with the people of the city at a low ebb. And at the Catholic Ballymurphy area, which has been at the centre of much of the trouble, the troops face particularly difficult problems. The responsibility for this area lies with the 16th Light Air Defence Regiment, and their company base on the edge of the Ballymurphy estate has been at the centre of the trouble.
I reference my request for Hawkeye to view these barricades. I think it would be a good idea if we had Hawkeye over to take a picture of them, over. Thank you.
was here at this field, at the rear of Springfield Park, that Father Mullen was shot. He'd been in his home about 150 yards away when word reached him that a man had been shot and wounded in the field. Father Mullen immediately left his house and rushed to the scene, braving a hail of crossfire as he did so. Waving a white handkerchief, he approached the wounded man. But as he did so, he was hit by a burst of automatic fire. He fell and began to crawl away, but was hit again. First aid men who'd seen the incident rushed forward to help him, but the gunfire continued. And an 18-year-old youth, Francis Reed, who'd also rushed to the scene, was shot through the head.
Of course, we couldn't get at him because we were pinned down by fire coming from the top of those houses, right? You know?
We were still flaking the field when he was lying there.
Yeah.
And nobody was there.
Correct.
What happened whenever the Red Cross finally did get to him?
They fired on the Red Cross.
They fired on the Red Cross. They kept firing. The army says, lay still. They put out in the lieutenant, lay still or you'll be shot.
If ever a man, there was a student at Red Cross.
He's a
student of the
Pakistani, Ali Akhilan.
If ever there was a brave man, that was a brave man. That man went into the field while they were firing on him and took the police body over his shoulders and carried it out and went back again and brought another boy out, the other dead boy out. And they were still firing at him when he was coming across.
Springfield area, and the husband just thought it would be safer for us to come here.
And when did you leave, and how
yesterday
did you...
Yesterday morning we left. Yesterday afternoon.
Tell me about your family.
Well, all my family's in Belfast. And my mother and father's in Ballymurphy. And our priest has just been shot dead.
And how many children have you?
I have six and my niece. Seven.
Where are you going?
I don't know where we're going now. Cork, as far as we know.
Have you got any money to look after yourself, or?
Oh, yes, I'm all right. You know, it's just fear that we left, because I thought we were safer for the children.
How many other refugees came across with you?
Well, we came on our own in a van. But whenever we got here, there was a few families here, and one lone woman. She stayed with us all night, but she's staying here, I don't know what for.
And how long are you prepared to be a refugee?
Oh, I don't know. I'd like to go home right now.
Well, good luck.
To the present, we have lost one brigade officer, one battalion officer, and the rest are volunteers, or as they say in the British Army, privates. We've lost two senior officers.
Where's that, in the whole of Belfast?
In Belfast, yeah.
The battle of the British Army hasn't been won. The losses in the IRA have been very slight, even in internment.
How many men of the provisionals and IRA proper lost during the last week?
We have lost 30 men arrested, 2 killed and 8 wounded. We had prior warning of this roundup. Consequently, we took the necessary precautions that there was nobody sleeping in their own homes or anything like that.
You mean that they haven't even got near the leaders at all?
They haven't, no.
What's going to happen to you now? You've given this, attended this press conference.
Well, I'll have to go deeper underground. I'll have to go deeper underground.
And tanks and guns came to take away our sons, but every man must stand behind the men behind the wire. Armored cars and tanks and guns came to take away our sons, but every man must stand behind the men behind the wire.
We can't take sides, you know. Protestant or Catholic, it makes no difference to us. We're soldiers. We've nothing to do with politics and anything like that. As for myself, I've no scruples about these people here. There you go. There's a shooting starter.
A shooting starter.
There we go. This infirmary at the bottom post. It's a full.
Brian Faulkner said one day, internment's here to stay, and with the stroke of his orange pen, to the Maidstone sent our men. Did you ever see such a stupid thing before? But old Brian, he did not know, our boys didn't want to go. And one upon a whim said, I think we'll take a swim. Did you ever see such a funny thing before? In the side they cut a hole, and one sliding down a pole, saying, boys, there's seven of us, so I think we'll take the bus. Did you ever see such a funny thing before? To the markets they did drive, and were helped when they arrived by our gallant Derrish folk, who laughed at this big joke. Did you ever see such a noble thing before? Now, Brian F., when will you learn that our boys you can't intern? As a parent, you'll expire. We'll have more come over the wire. Did you ever see such a funny thing before? Now the Irish are unbeatable, and that you will agree. Behind the wire or Crumlin Road are locked up by that sea. Will you ever learn that our boys will soon be free? Will you ever learn that our boys will soon be free?
was the latest of numerous petrol bomb attacks on Corrie's Woodyard on the fringe of the Catholic Ballymurphy estate, and it was by far the most destructive, burning for several hours and causing over £250,000 worth of damage. A local IRA leader said they started it at the request of residents because the timber shed roofs were being used as a vantage point by snipers firing into the Catholic houses. But the petrol bombers miscalculated. They forgot to allow for the wind, which spread the fire back into the housing estate, completely destroying two houses and a community centre. Many more houses were evacuated, and frightened residents pulled their furniture out into the streets and onto lorries so that it would be safe if the flames spread. Many spent the night in a local school. This morning they moved back to their homes, but first had to find their furniture left in the school playground. The two families whose homes were destroyed seemed unable to take in fully what had happened. Despite the makeshift barricades which had been around the estate for some time, the army today moved an entire company into this part of Ballymurphy. As well as Saracens, they brought with them Saladin armoured cars complete with 76mm guns, which have appeared on the streets of Belfast for the first time during this last week. Their job was to protect the men clearing up the debris inside the woodyard. The Catholics say that Protestant or army rifle fire from inside here has, during the last 2 weeks, killed five innocent people, including a priest and a 13-year-old girl. The army, who have an observation post inside the yard, deny the shots came from them, but agree that there has been firing at Catholic houses from the roof of this factory on the other side of the yard. They also say that they have often returned the fire of IRA men shooting from the roof of a Catholic chapel at soldiers on patrol in here.
A soldier was shot dead in Belfast this afternoon. He was on patrol in the Ballymurphy estate when two shots were fired.